Jack Higgins. I've recently been appointed part-time chaplain here at Lewisham and very happy to be one here. Just a short message. I'm still getting used to the college and so forth, so everything's fairly new. But as you know, we are coming up to Easter, celebration of Easter. Despite what people think, Easter is the biggest feast in the church, not Christmas. It's the foundation of everything that we believe in. And from Easter come all the other feasts and celebrations that we, that we have throughout the year. So my pleasant task here this morning, I know most of you have met me and I'm still a bit of a strange bird to most of the students anyway, but it's to wish each one of you a very happy and a very holy Easter. Holy in the sense of being able to be with your family and your friends and to celebrate all the good things that God has given us. It is a time of celebration, it's a celebration of life. God knows we do need something like that these days, considering what's going on in the world around us. So I do wish each and every one of you the blessing of the risen Christ and peace to all your families. God bless you.
Whenever I fall,
that were selling and buying in the temple. He overturned the table of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves. He said to them, "It is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers." The blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he cured them. But when the chief priests and the scribes saw these amazing things that he did, and heard the children crying out in the temple, "Hosanna to the Son of David," they became angry and said to him, "Do you hear what they are saying?" Jesus said to them, "Yes. Have you never read, 'Out of the mouths of infants and nursing babies, you have prepared praise for yourself?" He left them out of the city to Bethany and spent the night there.
We let Christ enter our world through Project Compassion.
We let Christ enter our world by attending church and reflecting on our sins.
Jesus enters our world on Easter Sunday as a resurrected Christ.
Christ enters our world through pain and suffering when Jesus was crucified on the cross.
We let Christ enter our heart at school when we learn about the Bible and all the work Jesus has done.
Let Christ enter our world through community as we see the people showing compassion, kindness and respect.
Let Christ enter our world in Russia and Ukraine. We pray for peace in that part of the world.
We need to let Christ enter our world through our friendships and relationships.
Christ enters our world through the natural environment, which brings us food, beauty, and oxygen.
I pray that Christ enters your life just for 1 minute, because when it does, it provides joy, freedom, and care.
We're coming up to one of the holiest times in the church year, a significant time as we lead ourselves towards Easter. In all the times of ourselves as a Catholic school, we're reminded of the presence of Christ, but that reminder is never more emphasised than this particular time. And we look to see Christ's presence in our own lives, in our school, and in the world.